Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Don't forget to make sure you're still subscribed, like, and share my videos. I really appreciate you taking your time to watch my videos. The National Geographic Institute, IGN as they're known by, has located about 63 earthquakes between Wednesday and Thursday morning. The largest within the last 3 days has been a magnitude 1.7. There has been two magnitude 2.2s. In the month of July, a total of 245 earthquakes were located in the area of the Canary Islands, the largest being a magnitude 3.6. That one was on the 16th and was close to the island of Tenerife. According to IGN, these earthquakes, after what they call a post-eruptive process, are normal. Here's a map showing the islands there in the Canary Islands. We got La Palma right there. And over here is Tenerife. IGN has measured very high concentrations of sulfur dioxide in the southernmost craters of the volcano Cumbre Vieja there on La Palma, despite the fact that it's been almost 8 months has elapsed since the end of its volcanic eruption. They are also saying that the presence of fumaroles with the high content of water vapor, which it clarifies is common in this post-eruptive phase. They are still working on rebuilding roads. Here you can see a new road that was recently laid. Yeah, I can't say much about the new road, but at least they got areas now where they can get into. I also found images there in Tenerife where they are putting in monitors to measure the amount of CO2. They also have a video, and the one thing that struck me was all the ash that is there, and I had a question, is this really Tenerife? What's going on there that we don't know about? I haven't been keeping up with this, that they are now measuring CO2. What the heck is going on? You notice over here all the ash that is on the stairs and along the sidewalk. I'll pull it over for you. Yeah, down there by the street. Yeah. I'm going to translate this tweet over here. It says, finally got all the data sent to the internet through 4G mobile communication. This network allows better monitoring and surveillance of the post-eruptive dangers of the volcanic eruption on the island of La Palma. Yeah, that's a lot of ash still in the streets 8 months after the eruption. So there was two questions posted to this video. It says, do you see the gases in that video? I do. I see the air that the two technicians breathe, atmospheric air. The CO2 concentrations measurement ranges up to 4%. So I went back to the video. I don't see CO2, but I did notice, where's all the people? I know that they are complaining about the lack of beds for tourism. They recently removed ash from 400 more buildings. Another image of IGN putting in monitors. And another one. So evidently they're going to put in 10 locations where the measurements of CO2 concentrations are going to be monitored and acquired with sampling of data every 5 minutes. Now, they're saying that a few days ago, the IGN and the Volcanological Institute of the Canary Islands, INVOCAN, and the Geological and Mining Institute of Spain, IGME, published videos on the internet showing holes in the ground with incandescent lava near the crater of the volcano of La Palma at very shallow depths, with temperatures reaching 1,000 degrees. Here is part of one of the videos showing the fumaroles, the gases coming up. Here's another capture from one of the craters. It says it's sprinkled with sulfur deposits. Now that would be this yellow stuff here. and cracks through which we can find out temperatures in the ground, in this case only 11 centimeters, about 4 inches deep, which is reading 184.3. Now that evidently is from the 8th of this month, just a few days ago. Alright, here's showing the lava, and you can see the lava. Really shallow under the volcano. It says, like every day we go up to the crater, we are accompanied by the spectacular incandescence in which we continue to measure temperatures above 800 degrees Celsius. Yeah, that is shallow. How can they say that this thing is no longer erupting? So that would be 1,400 degrees Fahrenheit. Yeah, one of the responses to this video says the color is red. It is still alive. I agree. This volcano is still alive. Sulfur dioxide, SO2, posted on August 9th, remains one of the targets of our measurements in the crater, revealed by the characteristic of its blue hue. It is monitored by our scientists to understand what processes are taking place almost 8 months after its eruption ended. Yeah, maybe it's just taking a break. I don't know. All right, so I made the image larger so you can see the gases that are coming up. And yeah, what are your thoughts about this? 245 earthquakes just last month. And yeah, at least 30 so far that they're reporting from the 1st through the 13th of August. They're working really hard to try and get more tourists in through the airports with some kind of an agreement. I don't know what. It's rather confusing. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing my videos. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.